the many substitution scams, information provided to H.E. Cardinal Mamberti and the Vatican Chancery Court in regard to our claims, March 5, 2005, January 19, 2023, in SEEK. The same perpetrators who put Abraham Lincoln up for election as a president instead of the president have also practiced a wide range of other substitution schemes of the same kind, applied to other things. In addition to having the presidents of foreign municipal corporations substituted for the presidents of our unincorporated sovereign government organizations, we have had a glittering array of false confederations and false federations, too. Just because something is called a confederation or a federation does not mean that it is the confederation or the federation that we all think of. The same way the perpetrators substituted a president for the president, they have substituted a confederation for the confederation and a federation for the federation and a union for the union. Our national-level government, which represents the joined soil jurisdictions of all our states acting together as the union of our nation-states. But notice, that during the Civil War, the same words, the Union, were applied to the Alliance of Northern States of States, former members of the Confederation formed in 1781, and the British Territorial Municipal Subcontractors doing business as the United States of America, Inc. The only thing that gives us a clue that the Union isn't the same thing as the Union is the capitalization of the definite article, the, and if people know nothing about English grammar and proper names, they will pass right over that important difference and assume that the union of our nation states fought in the so-called American Civil War. Nothing could be further from the truth, but this is how things get confused, a combination of ignorance, duplicity, and false assumptions. Just as there are many constitutions all over the world, not just our three famous federal constitutions, there are many federations and confederations, too, but so long as people remain ignorant of this fact, it's easy to confuse them and pull the same old trick, substituting a federation or a confederation for our federation of states or our confederation of states of states. For example, the Scottish Municipal Corporation that booted up in 1868 and which substituted itself a foreign commercial corporation calling itself the United States of America for our federation of states. It declared itself a federation of states, appearing to be our federation of states, for purposes of fraud and impersonation, with two very important and undisclosed differences. 1. The Scottish pretender was a British territorial municipal corporation in no way related to, much less the same as, our unincorporated American Federation of States. They impersonated our unincorporated Federation of States, infringed on our venerable trademarks, and hid their status as a foreign incorporated entity in order to gain unauthorized access to our credit, just like a modern-day credit card hacker impersonates their victims and pretends to be the owner of the account. The colluding banks knew better, but looked the other way and failed to protect the account holders, acts for which they are still liable. 2. The Scottish usurper also misrepresented the nature of the member states in their federation. Our federation's members are all organic states with physical substance. Their federation's members were all incorporated franchises operated as territorial states of states. So not only were the members of their federation not states, but were incorporated franchises of the parent municipal corporation instead. They used another semantic deceit to hide this. States of states are also called Confederate states, so they simply omitted the word Confederate and pretended that their states were equivalent to our states. Their deceit and the substitution of their foreign corporation impersonating our unincorporated Federation of States was complete. They even set up an extra constitution for themselves, the so-called corporate constitution published in 1868 to expedite the rest of their fraud. They published a copy of the Constitution of the United States of America with three tiny alterations and redefined it to serve in a completely different jurisdiction of the law. The articles were now taken to be articles of incorporation and the amendments were redefined as by-law amendments that didn't need any ratification by the actual states. The members of the Territorial Congress were also redefined and were no longer operating as fiduciary deputies owing good faith service to the people of this country, but were now redefined as proxies and representatives, Elected by the shareholders of their corporation, the Scottish usurper doing business as the United States of America, Incorporated. Again, the banks knew and did nothing to protect their depositors' identities, assets or credit, thereby becoming knowing and willing accomplices to these crimes. The fraud and the impersonation and the substitution schemes are wide and deep, with foreign incorporated entities pretending to be unincorporated American organizations, substituting their presidents for our president, our state of state organizations for their territorial and municipal state of state organizations, their federations of confederate states for our federation of organic states, their confederations of foreign state of state franchises for our confederation of states, and they even managed to an extent to obscure the nature of the federal republic as a separate business entity operated by the states of America. The one thing that all these substitution scams have in common is that they strive to substitute European imposters operating outside their natural jurisdiction for our American government organizations, and they deliberately seek to confuse their organizations and offices and even their elections with ours. Billions of dollars are now poured into and wasted on private municipal corporation elections that have been deceitfully substituted in the public eye for our public elections. This inordinate emphasis on electing undisclosed proxy holders and foreign corporation officers is a reflection of the wealth and power these jokers obtain as our purported representatives. We wish for the world to realize these people do not represent us in the capacities that they have merely assumed. We wish for people everywhere to realize the conditions of deceit and manipulation and violence that the American people have lived under at the hands of these criminal municipal corporation service providers for over 150 years. These foreign municipal corporations, hired as service vendors, have abused our good names and assets for their own unjust enrichment, and have unleashed a culture of crime and have imposed a form of corporate feudalism on dozens of countries that have been similarly defrauded and misrepresented. We wish for the end of all pretenses of war among the municipal corporation employees that have been allowed to stay here under the provisions of the Residence Act, and an end to any presumption that these municipal corporations serve us in any custodial or fiduciary capacity not explicitly and specifically granted to them as a treaty obligation or delegated power. We wish for the forfeiture of the colluding banks that have acted as expediters and accomplices to these crimes against their primary depositors and preferential creditors. We wish for everyone to know that our property assets, including but not limited to the DNA of our people, and all other assets in all jurisdictions that naturally belong to our people and our lawful government, are not abandoned, and our claim to our assets is not compromised by all the false undisclosed registrations and other self-interested fraud schemes that have attempted to steal our identity and unlawfully convert our political status and standing. The confusion that has resulted from all these substitution schemes is daunting, as are the name changes and same names applied to different things during different years. We do not underestimate the difficulties that all these issues cause for people who are trying to make sense of the convoluted and deliberately obfuscated facts. What it comes down to is this: our states never participated in the so-called American Civil War, which was an undeclared, illegal mercenary conflict from the start. There is no declaration of war from our Congress related to the American Civil War. There is no muster roll from any state, only states of states. There is no peace treaty ending this mercenary conflict, only a contractual obligation established by three public declarations made by territorial President Andrew Johnson guaranteeing peace on the land. We are the inheritors of these peace declarations and contractual guarantees, grandfathered in since 1866. The territorial military owes us the law of peace and has owed us that continuously and regardless of any other circumstance or controversy. It is our position that regardless of Franklin Delano Roosevelt's reopening of hostilities between the two municipal corporation subcontractors in 1933, both those parties resolved their differences by collusion when they signed the Declaration of Interdependence of the Governments in the United States in 1937. Our population is owed exemption from any suspicion or maltreatment or harassment or presumption of debt, and also owed all constitutional guarantees and services we are heir to since 1866. and the employees and agents of the municipal corporation subcontractors are contractually bound together as a cooperative entity since 1937. Our position is that both the offending municipal corporation subcontractors are ultimately owned by the same principals regardless of who operates them, so our claims are directly addressed to the principals responsible and we bypass any illusion otherwise. We wish for the end of all efforts to construct a modern form of corporate feudalism as a world government and the arrest of anyone still promoting this against the interests of our lawful national governments. We have seen corporate feudalism and have no need to see it again. Issued by Anna Maria Riesinger, fiduciary. The United States of America in care of Box 520,994 Big Lake, Alaska 99652. April 23, 2023,